My next guest, James Jamison, has enjoyed a stellar career as a dancer, choreographer, and teacher on the international scene. He began his career in the 1940s in the original productions of Oklahoma and Brigadoon, and has since danced and choreographed in most of the leading stock companies both on and off Broadway. He performed in the White House for President Kennedy and has worked extensively with Agnes DeMille, both in theater and on television. He's been a real bright spot on the Delaware arts scene, having established and operated the Academy of the Dance in Wilmington, Delaware for the past 25 years, as well as serving on the Delaware Arts Council for 10 years. Mr. Jamison, welcome. It's a pleasure to have you here.
And it's very nice to meet you.
Thank you. Mr. Jamison, there's so much to talk about, and there's so much that you've done, but one of the reasons that you're here tonight, of course, is to boost Lillian Balick's efforts in behalf of Delaware Young Musicians. What comments would you make on that line?
Well, I've been very interested in this program since its inception, and I have attended every single one of the concerts.
Oh.
And just by accident, one evening one of the members was not able to appear, so I had to fill in with Lillian in order to help award the prizes and so forth. It's a very, very exciting program, and not just in Delaware, but throughout our country. Most of these competitions are done through festivals of
yes.
the arts or what have you. This one is exclusively done as an event.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think Delaware should be proud of that fact.
They should be very proud,
mm-hmm.
and especially of the people who have gone on from being a recipient of an award and then going on into the profession, very big.
Mm. Now, I understand that you're giving a lecture demonstration on Sunday, March 1st, at the Jewish Community Center in connection with this. Tell us a little bit about your involvement.
Well, we are going to do a program in two parts. The first part will be the lecture demonstration, which we show the basic principles and development of the steps up to the more advanced steps and coda, and which you'll see them turn very fast. And then the second part will be a ballet by Mr. Victor Wesley, who came to the Academy in 1970. He's a Scottish boy.
Mm-hmm.
Then he went back and he danced with Scottish Ballet. And then Boston Ballet came here in 1975, emigrated. He's danced with the Boston Ballet. And now he has been doing choreography. And he is going to present a Bach concerto, which is very interesting, with our students from the school.
Hmm. Now, you've had quite an exciting career yourself in dance and theater. Why don't we discuss some of your career highlights, and how did you start out professionally? I'm interested.
Well, first of all, I danced Highland dancing because my parents were Scottish. Lots of people think I have an accent. I don't know if I do or not. But they were Scottish, and so I learned how to do the Highland fling at a very early age.
Do you still do that?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I just helped with the revival of Brigadoon, which is playing in New York,
mm-hmm.
and we restaged the dances that were done originally in the show by Mr. Mill.
Mm-hmm.
And so that was the first part, and then I started. I went to Northwestern University to study theater, and then I decided I wanted to dance. So I first started with a lady in Chicago by the name of Edna McCrae, and then I danced in a Polish ballet. Then I danced with the Littlefield Ballet, which incidentally was one of the first American ballet companies to be recognized, and they were from Philadelphia.
When was this?
In the Chicago Civic Opera. Just before the war, and then of course the war came along. I was overseas, and I was a lieutenant in the service. And then when I came back, I joined Oklahoma, and that's how I met Mr. Mill.
The Broadway show.
No, this was the National Touring Company.
I see.
In Chicago,
mm-hmm.
and then she had me come to assist her with Brigadoon, and thereby hangs a tale. I've seen the entire world through my career.
Mm. Now, what were some of your favorite projects?
Well, of course, you mentioned the White House. That was a very exciting evening. It was February the 27th.
Why don't you share some of your memories in connection with
1963,
that?
And we were doing King and I at the Drama League,
mm-hmm.
and so I had the night off, and I went down to the White House to do the sword dance, and there were three. Mr. Bilella was the central figure, and then I danced on his right-hand side. And it was a very memorable occasion, and we were invited to see the entire White House and the collection. It was very, very beautiful.
Hmm. Now, 25 years ago, you co-founded the Academy of the Dance in Wilmington. Where's the Academy
Helena looking? Antonova,
with, yes.
Who was a member of the Diaghilev Ballet. That's very important because her background is still in the school. She danced with the company that came from Russia, the first company that came out of Russia, you see, and under Diaghilev's direction. So that her contribution while she was with us was tremendous. And we still tried to carry on, you know, what we thought, what we had originally planned in our school.
Where's your theater? Our
academy is at 209 West 14th Street, mm-hmm. right in the heart of Wilmington.
What made you decide to settle in Delaware, of all places?
Well, I was asked to come to stage the Dances of Brigadoon in 1954.
Yes.
Mr. W.W. Laird, who incidentally is very, very, was very active at that time in amateur production, and who really did tremendous amount for the arts in Delaware, and they came to interview me, and I came down to Wilmington, and when Madame Antonova, we drove down along the Brandywine, she looked up and she said, "This is where we must come and have school," and so we did. It was easy as that.
Now, what's your response to the criticism that young men don't want to enter into the field of ballet? Is it acceptable now?
Well, you must remember that the arts are very young, and dancing especially in our country, very, very young. People in Europe have been doing these things for 200 years or more, you know. For instance, I went to Russia in 1977 and saw the schools, the Bolshoi School and the Leningrad-Kirov School, and but even there they had difficulty in getting young men to dance, and there's something about it that is, it's very difficult. It's not an easy way to make a living, mm-hmm. first of all, and you spend arduous hours practicing all of your life, and then if you're smart you keep on going, you know, after that, because it keeps you in good shape. But in general, look, now it's different now. However, we had more boys in our production of Nutcracker this year than ever before, and they did extremely well, mm-hmm. so that men are in our country are beginning to take a liking to dancing, and the parents the most important are not afraid to have their sons dance, per se, the Reagans.
That's right. Well, we don't have any more time. Do you have any final short comments on the JCC contest?
Oh, it is truly a wonderful thing, and the people should try to see the final performance of the finalists. Fascinating performance, because they need that experience. We all need the experience to perform. And you will see in our part of the program young people who will dance. We hope.
Well, thank you for coming on. I hope you'll stick around. We'll be right back with more of the show right after these few messages. Right.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was great.
Focus Delaware will return after these messages.